Mrs. Cardwell. Yeah. I'm Dr. Shakarchan. I'm one of the doctors in the emergency room.
What was your name?
Dr. Shakarchan. I usually go by Dr. S.
Dr. S. Oh, that's nice. Okay.
Nice to meet you. I'm one of the doctors in the emergency room.
Yes.
And who's here with you today?
Oh, this is Gloria. She's my everything. She helps me a lot.
Actually, I'm Mrs. Cardwell's caregiver. I'm the one who called the doctor tonight. She's just not breathing like she should.
Thank you for being here, Gloria. Mrs. Cardwell, is it okay for Gloria to stay while I ask you some questions?
Oh, of course. She needs to stay, yes.
Fantastic. And is it okay with you if I ask her a couple of questions once we're done chatting?
Oh, of course. Uh-huh.
Thank you. How are you feeling?
Oh, I'm fine, but I'm tired, very tired.
Well, I'm glad you're here. Can you tell me a little bit more about what is bringing you into the emergency room?
I don't really know. I thought we had an appointment, but I'm just very, very tired.
I promise I'll let you get some rest. I just need to ask a few questions to see what's been going on.
All right. That's fine, dear. That's fine.
Are you feeling short of breath?
I guess I have trouble getting air a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me how long that's been going on?
Oh, for months, I think.
No, Mrs. Cardwell. It's been much, much worse the past couple of days, remember?
Oh, that's right. It has. Uh-huh.
Oh, thank you, Gloria. What's been making it worse?
I don't know. I'm not sure, dear. I'm not sure. Okay. I feel fine.
Okay. Have you had any cough?
Not really, I guess.
All right. What about any chest pain? Get pressure in your chest?
Oh, no. All right. I don't know.
Okay. What about any chest pain when you take a deep breath? Like if you go like...
like, oh, you know, you're right. There was something. Ooh.
Are you okay?
I'm all right, thank you.
And what about any runny nose or a sore throat?
Oh, I don't have a sore throat, but you know, my nose is runny. Do you have a clean tissue for me?
Of course. Her nose is pretty congested. I have her use that saline spray to try and flush things out.
Anything make the breathing better that you've noticed, Mrs. Cardwell?
Anything makes it better? I don't know.
What about your COPD medications?
My what?
Like the breathing treatments that you get with the machine.
Oh, that, you mean the steamy machine.
That's a great name for it. Yeah, the steamer.
Yeah, I like that. That's good, huh, Gloria? I like that. Okay. Helps.
Thank you so much for answering my questions, Mrs. Cardwell. If it's okay with you, I'm just going to ask Gloria some questions.
That'd be lovely, dear. You just go ahead.
All right. Thank you. Gloria, can you tell me a little bit more about what made you bring Mrs. Cardwell in today?
Well, besides the difficulty breathing, she's been a little bit confused. I've been with her now for 5 years. I'm with her every day except for Sundays. I take care of her and her house, stay all day. Mm-hmm. And I just got concerned about what was going on. She's like my family at this point.
Oh, and Gloria's my family, too. Whoa. She's wonderful, just wonderful.
Oh, I'm glad to hear that. Can you tell me a little bit more about what's been going on with her breathing?
Well, she's been having difficulty breathing for the past 4 days now, but it got so much worse this past day that I did call the house call doctor just a little bit before dinner time. Normally, she's up at 9, I make her breakfast, she sits in her recliner, she watches her TV shows and naps, and then we go out for a little walk, but she's been so tired this past day, I couldn't even get her out of bed this morning. I ended up taking all of her meals to her there.
And I noticed that she's wearing oxygen. Does she wear oxygen at home too?
Yeah, she's been using oxygen ever since I've been working for her. Normally 2 liters, but as I mentioned, I had to increase that to 4 liters. I make sure that her tank is always full and that she doesn't trip over any cords or tubing.
Thank you so much for watching out for her safety. That's really important. Any other symptoms that you've noticed, like swollen legs?
Well, her legs are always a little bit swollen, but nothing more than usual. She does have the runny nose. That's off and on. And she doesn't complain about chest pain. In fact, she's not much of a complainer at all, except for the pain in her knees when she walks. But as you can see, she's definitely coughing. I'm hearing her cough and nothing is coming up. In fact, the nighttime caregivers told me that she's just not sleeping well because she coughs and then she's out of breath. So they managed to sit her up more when she's sleeping to help her breathe, but I can't tell if that's helping or not.
Okay. That's very helpful. Have you guys tried any of the breathing treatments when she gets short of breath?
Of course, I do have her nebulizer machine. Normally, I'll give her maybe one or two breathing treatments every couple of days, but for the past 4 days, it's been 4 times a day. I think it helps her breathe, but I notice that sometimes she coughs a lot after the nebulizer, and I can't help but wonder maybe we should be doing it more often.
I see. The fact that she's been needing it a more than normal makes me a little bit worried. Has that ever happened before?
Yeah, she has had a flare-up of her COPD, and that's what I'm concerned about happening again. In fact, the house calls doctor last winter came to see her and told me that she had a virus and a flare-up of the COPD, and she gave her some steroids. Which made Mrs. Cardwell feel a little bit restless, but I think they helped. Okay. Do you think maybe we should try that again?
It certainly could be that she's having another flare-up of her COPD, but it's really important to make sure there's nothing else going on and that we're not missing another cause of her shortness of breath or maybe something else that could be contributing. has there been anybody sick around her?
Actually, yes. One of the new nighttime caregivers came to work and she was sick. And when I got there the following morning, this lady was blowing her nose and coughing, and she actually looked like she had a fever to me. So I immediately called the agency and told them that they can't send these floating people anymore because they don't care if they get Mrs. Cardwell sick.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Thank you so much for advocating for her so much. And you told me about the fact that her swellings in her legs are not that much changed. Have you ever noticed one leg being more swollen than the other?
No, I don't think so. Okay. And I do try to keep them propped up on her ottoman when she's in her recliner to keep the water out.
Okay. That's great. And have you been taking her vitals at home?
I did tonight because I was particularly worried because she's feeling so poorly. Made a quick note.
Thank you.
Tonight, her oxygen was 89%, and that was on the 4 liters. Her pulse was 96. I normally take these every morning before her medication, and I do have yesterday's numbers, if that's helpful.
That would be very helpful. Thank you.
Her heart rate yesterday morning was 92, but that was before her heart rate medicine. Her oxygen was better. It was 93%, but that was also on the 4 liters. And I believe her normal oxygen level is 94% on 2 liters.
That's very helpful. Thank you for bringing that in. Sure. Has she had any falls recently?
Not recently. She did fall 2 years ago and had to have her hip fixed. But ever since then, we've been using her walker whenever she walks.
Yeah.
I'm so glad you've been using your walker.
Yes. Yeah. It works. She makes me use it.
Okay, good. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, Gloria. It was very helpful information. Can I ask you a couple of more questions, Mrs. Cardwell?
Yes, dear. That would be fine.
Have you been feeling feverish, like you're very hot?
No, but, you know, I could use more of that blanket.
Okay. Do you have any chills?
Not chills. It's just very cold in these rooms.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Let me get you your blanket.
They keep it like ice in here.
Yeah, that is so true.
Oh, that's much better. Thank you.
Is this better?
Ooh, yeah, thank you.
Good.
Excuse me.
No worries at all. How is your appetite these days?
Oh, my appetite's not what it used to be, you know. The food just doesn't taste very good. You know, they won't let me put any salt in my food.
Oh,
they won't
I see.
Let me have any.
What about any problems with your bowels, any diarrhea or constipation?
No, dear, not at all.
Have you thrown up at all or feel nauseous?
No, I haven't. Nothing like that. Yeah. Just tired.
I see. And how are you sleeping at night?
I sleep fine, dear. Thank you.
Okay. And how is your mood?
My mood?
Do you feel happy, sad?
Oh. Well, Gloria makes me very happy.
Good.
And I guess I get a little sad sometimes because I miss my daughter. You know, she lives in Los Angeles, and I miss my husband. He passed away a while ago, and I miss him.
That seems very hard. How long were you guys married?
We were married 50 years.
That's,
can you believe that?
That's incredible.
50 years. It would be almost 60 if he were still alive.
Wow. You told me about your daughter that she's in LA. Do you have any family around the city?
Oh, my granddaughter. You know, she's staying up here because she goes to law school.
Hey, you must be very proud.
Oh, I am. She's a wonderful girl. She's so smart, you know.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. How often do you get to see her?
She comes every Sunday. Every
Good.
Sunday.
Come to think of it, this past Sunday, her granddaughter came to take her to church, but she was just too tired to go this time.
I was, and she just stays and visited with me. We had lunch together, and then she had to go back. I didn't get to go to church.
I'm glad at least you got to see her.
Oh, it's wonderful. She's a very good girl.
Good. And have you noticed any weight loss?
Me? No, I don't know. I don't know.
Actually, I think she has lost a little bit of weight, even though we're giving her very good food. I noticed that her pants seem to be getting a little bit looser these past couple months.
Thank you so much for letting me know that. Have you been able to weigh her recently?
I can't. The last time I tried, I actually hurt my back trying to hold her up on the scale. But the house calls doctor did weigh her a few months ago, and I think she was 118 at that time. I do manage to keep an eye on her legs to watch her fluid levels.
I'm so sorry about your back pain.
Okay.
And thank you both so much for talking to me and giving me all of this information. I'm just going to go check your chart really quickly and then come back and do a physical exam if that's okay with you.
Oh, I guess that's fine, dear, fine.
And hopefully in the meantime, you can get some rest.
I hope so. I'm just so very tired.
It was really nice meeting you both. I'm glad you're here.
It was nice meeting you too.
Okay, I'll see you in a little bit. Mm-hmm.